CSI is funded by the USAID from the American people.
Artisanal fisheries subsector provides both direct and indirect jobs to thousands of women in fishing communities. Their survival is tied to fishing. Odelia, a 22-year-old senior high school graduate, her source of livelihood was the income generated through sale of wood fuel and head porter, popularly referred to as kayaye. At the time, she needed money urgently to pursue post-secondary education.
As fish stock declines, so has income for households that depend on fishing.
But there is hope for Odelia. She's beneficiary of a USAID-sponsored vocational training that aims to build economic resilience in fishing communities by improving women and youth with alternative livelihoods as pathways to reduce pressure on Ghana's fish stock and to build economic resilience. She's excited and looks forward to a hopeful future.
I've been helping my mom with fishing. She's a porter at the beach, so I always help her. Sometimes when she buys the fish, we bring it to the house. So it's very tedious and stressful because walking from the beach across the route is very stressful.
She said it's her dream to become a good caterer. She added that being gainfully employed will reduce vulnerability to men who exploit unemployed women due to financial constraints.
Since the beach is not producing anything, before you feed, you need to sell yourself to get money for it. So when you go to my area now, you see like a lot of teenage pregnancy going on, and then it's very common in my community. Due to what I'm learning now, I can do something quickly and then get something to put in my pocket.
Odelia is hopeful she can work to raise money and enroll in a nursing school. Her colleagues, also beneficiaries of the vocational training, were elated about non-fisheries income-based jobs.
We don't do only baking. We do cooking too and beverages. So I've learned those things. We do jollof rice, fried rice, benku, donuts, spring rolls, cake, meat pie, and sobolo, lamuji, local moths, and asana.
When it's time for fishing season, we go to the beach. We help, I have a lot of friends there, so we just help them. As we just go back home, do our normal things. Some years to come, there will be no fish in the sea, so at least we need to get something for ourselves because we can't rely solely on the sea to survive. So at least with this, it will help us, especially with the youth. Without the sea, we can still survive. I've learned a lot in terms of cooking, various ways of cooking, how to mix stuff for cakes and other pastries. I can say so far so good.
Joseph Armstrong, Good Aloko TV 3, Keita, Volta Region.
Fisher's Eye is funded by the USAID from the American people.